So Matt gave us this this morning. Thank you, Matt. All right. So Endeavor topic, is the new move a pullback or a reversal? I think this gets more traders than anything. All right. So that was the question. So here's my, I went to Investopedia and I said, what is a pullback? All right. Here's what Investopedia says. It's a pullback is a pause or moderate drop in stock or commodities pricing chart from recent peaks, keyword there, peaks, that occur in a continuing uptrend. A pullback is very similar to a retracement or consolidation, and the terms are sometimes used interchangeably. The term pullback is usually applied to pricing drops that are relatively short in duration, for example, a few consecutive sessions before the uptrend resumes. Now, you can quickly see that they are writing this from a stock perspective, because in a stock perspective, you buy and hold, right? Now, in the Forex, we actually short more than we buy. Right. So there's the first problem with that. But the real key word there are peaks and a few consecutive sessions before the uptrend resumes. All right. So let's take a look at that. Here's the most common. Bull and bear flags are pullbacks. An ABC is a pullback, most likely inside a bull or a bear flag, but it doesn't have to be. All right. And a flash pullback. All right. Why do they happen? There's a loss of sufficient buyers or sellers to continue. Remember, in the Forex, everything is about continuation, all right? There are 14 chart patterns in the Forex that we care about. We don't care about three crows and three black soldiers and all that stuff they got in the stock market. We don't care about that. But the 14 patterns that we do care about, only four of them are reversal. 10 of them are continuation, because in the Forex, once they have spent billions and billions of dollars to build a channel or a range or a trend, they need to continue it to get a return on investment, all right? So the question is, how do you deal with them, all right? Well, the number one way to deal with them is your stop policy, and that's one reason why you have to embrace entering with only one third of your lots and exiting, and then adding the other two thirds along the way with three times the stop, right? That's what you got to do, right? That will keep you out of most pullbacks, right? Not on the big, big, big currencies, but on most pullbacks, they're going to have to pull back their entire ATR to get your stop if you do that, right? And the chances of that happening, while possible, are not probable. Does everybody understand that? The chance of doing the pullback against you means that with the proper stop on your first position, means that in most cases, it's going to have to do an entire ATR against you to get that stop. Now, if you're sitting in front of that computer, you will never let it go the entire ATR back to your stop. So you got 100 pip stop on a third of your lots, and you see it goes 30, 35, 40, 50. What should you do? And it shows no sign of slowing down. You click it out for 50 pip loss instead of 100 pip loss. But it was only on 1/3 of your lots, and you are going to get caught. There is no way around it. You are going to get caught. So that's why you have to embrace it, all right? So that's the first thing, stop policy. And then the other thing is understanding the structure, right? So I did a little homework and got a couple of pictures here so we could, instead of just shooting through the charts, I could show you a couple here, all right? Now, you can see this is a very ugly ABC, but it is an ABC, A, B, C, all right? And that C should have stopped in here, but they didn't find any sellers, so they had to go higher, all right? Here's the key thing. Did we make a higher high or do we make a lower low? Do we make a higher high or a lower low? Excuse me, that's wrong. I said it wrong. Do we make a higher high or do we make a lower high? That's what I should have said. There we go. A lower high. Thanks. Yeah. Sorry, I confused you. Yeah. All right. So what does that tell you? Now, you can immediately see what they did with that information. Here's what they did with that information. All right. So the ABC set it up. It is definitely a pullback. It is definitely a pullback. But what did they do with the information? The lower high said we topped out. All right. And so they immediately find the sellers and down they go. Does everybody see that? All right. You can see the school is the past. If you have a question, go ask the chart in the past. See? And that'll tell you. right? It'll tell you, right, what it is, right? So there you go, right? So there's one, all right? Here's the other one. This is very clearly a bear flag with an A, B, C right there. There's what they did with that information right there. All right, what did we make? Another lower high, all right? So are you getting the idea that when I get a pullback, it is an opportunity because the pullback is my friend. If I'm going down and I make a lower high, I need to look for the opportunity. If I'm going up, I need to look for the higher low, all right? Does that make sense to everybody? All right. We'll go in the charts and see some, but I want to show some that I just pulled out for you, all right? So there you go, all right. Let's look at the next one here, all right? So here we have a flash pullback, all right? Well, a flash pullback means they just charged up the hill. They didn't do an ABC, they didn't do anything, they just charged up the hill. Once again, what did they do? Lower high. You see the close in reverse right there? That's what the big boys did with it. That's what they did with it. Here's the follow through. That's what they did with it. See that? That's what they did with it. All right? Then, once again, another A, B, C to the top. Here's what the big boys did with it. Close in reverse. Here's what the follow-through did with it. What was the key there? Lower high, lower high, lower high. So they know it's not a reversal. It's an attempt to find enough sellers to make the move. Does everybody see that? That's pretty clear in these examples here that I got. Everybody see it? All right. So there's a couple of them right there, right? Then, all right, oh, that's it. So let's go in the charts and let's see if we can't find some here, all right? So here you got, right here, you're in New Zealand, we're just on it right here. And we got, what do we have? Can everybody see we have an A, B, C right there, all right? Now you can see the close in reverse right there from the big boys. And there's the first follow through coming through. They don't find enough sellers. So what do? They do a bear flag pullback. There's the result of that. And there's what the traders did with that information. You see it? It's clear as a bell. The past is your school, folks. If you're not spending 3 hours in the past for every 1 hour you trade, you're not going to make it. That's what it takes. 3 hours in the past for every 1 hour you trade. What does a retail trader want to do? I just want to trade, man. I wasn't going to trade. It's just, where's the trade? Where's the trade? Don't push the button. Wait for the trade to come to you. All right. That's what they did. All right. They waited and then they waited and they took the money. That's what they did. All right. Now, here's the problem with this one. And we already talked about that. Is that a bear flag? All right. If it's a bear flag, it needs to at least move up into this area for the A, B, C. Does everybody see that? And we don't have that yet. All right. And that's en route to our target today. All right. Chart says we might possibly go up, all right? Now, if this takes off and goes up, all right? It takes off and goes up, but doesn't make the target and turns right here, what should I look for? What are my key things there? The A and the C, good question, A. The A and the C are typically the same size. So you measure that from here to here, whatever that is, once the B starts, whatever that is what that will be in size. So it's probably right up, yeah, right in that area right there, see? Now you can actually measure that, see? You can measure that and see how many pips that is. When you know the B is in, you can measure it straight up, all right? So there you go, all right? Now we got clues here. You got a close and reverse right there. You got bulls coming in trying to push it. You're almost at a zero line break. Okay. Yeah. So you look for a close and reverse to the downside, as Vess has said, and you look for what? A lower high. A lower high. If it makes a lower high and you see the close in reverse, Well, they weren't done with this one over here. This is an ABC pullback to do that run right there, right? See that? That finished it off at the top. See, that's, it's a nasty one. I just opened, that's the chart I opened. So that's, I used it because every chart is a school, All right. So there's an interesting look at that one. Let's go look at that pound Aussie that we're looking at to the downside. All right. So let's take a look at this now and see what it looks like. All right. So, all right. So they did a flash pullback. All right. Then they did a flag to the top. Let's see what they did with that information. That's what they did with it. Went to the top. There's the close in reverse at the top. There's the follow through. That's what they did with the information. So you can always see what they did with the information. And now we're having trouble. All right. As you can see, we're just chop, 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 chop. As they're trying, there's a lot of indecision in the market here. All right. So, but we know several factors. We're below the moving average on the zero line. So that means we're officially a seller. We're also below the T3. There's that and there's that. All right, if I have a T3 break and a zero line break, what is my percentage chance of going in that direction? What's my percentage chance? 82%. See, so because I know that I have an 82% trade to the downside in terms of direction, all right, will the chart prove that? Will the chart prove it? That's the whole key there, see? Now, all right, so let's not talk about a pullback here. That's just what it is, okay? It's trying to go, as you can see right now. And maybe they'll break it. I don't know. We'll see. All right. Let's look at the other ones we had over here to the EJ. All right. So here's the EJ. All right. So how did they make this whole move happen? All the way up. All the way up. What did they do to make it happen? All right. So they had a little thing. Then had a retracement, which set up the flag. All right. There's the break, hook, and go, which set up that movement. Then they have a flash pullback to the T3, and they get immediately start up, but they don't find enough sellers. So what do? Come back down to find the sellers. This time they find the sellers right there, and that continues on up, all right? Then they do another sideways move, which continues is up, and then what are they doing? A, B, C to the downside, which set up this move right here. This is what they did with that information. Does everybody see it? That's what they did with it. See, we have to do what they do. Doing what you do isn't going to get you anywhere. You doing what they do will make you a trader, all right? Now, then we hit the top here, and you see we have a close in reverse right there, all right? So a little bear flag there. Down they go. They're not successful. They do another pullback here, another pullback. Not very big, but that's what resulted in that pullback, all right? Then they do a sideways movement here, and that's what resulted in that movement, all right? See, all right? Forensics. You can go back to any single move, and you can tell what did they do to make it happen, all right? Now, I agree if you're on MT4, you can't see it because you can't see bright green candles or red candles. You can't see that stuff. So you're blind if you're trying to trade MT4. But if you're not on MT4 and you're on our charts, it's a breeze, okay? Let's go back over here, all right? All right, so what set this move to the upside? You see it all went up. What set it up? A big pullback. Can you see it? A, B, C, right there. That set up that move, all right? That's what set it up, all right? Do we make a lower low? No, we didn't even come close. I bet if you pop a fib on that, you're going to find that it's a fib, so let's just do it. All right, we'll pop a fib on it from a swing low to a swing high, and there it is. All right, so they tried to turn it to 50, normal. They were not successful. So what did they do? We got to go down a little further. So this is where they put the B wave in right there. That created the C wave to the downside. All right, they made the turn. Why? Because of the 119 even number right there. Right there, see that? And from that point on, everything went up. Took it a while, but there it is. All right, here's two pullbacks. All right, now see, these are retracements. That's a retracement. That's a retracement. That's a retracement. All right, this is a retracement. This is a retracement. Those are retracements, okay? All right, but this is a pullback and this is a pullback. Does everybody see the difference between the two of them? These are retracements in here. All right, these are retracements in here. This is the pullback. This is a pullback. All right. So remember, why did they do that? Because if they run out of buyers in the case of an up move like this, they have to go find sellers. Professional traders do not sell at the bottom. At the top. Professional traders sell at the bottom. And so the obvious question from neophytes is, well, wait a minute, there's a close and reverse right there. That's exactly right, because this whole move was manipulated, all right? So sell at the top, right? Thanks, Donald, all right? So this move right here was a manipulated move by the bankers to get down to where the sellers are. Don't forget, they know where they are because they can see them. You and I can't see them, but they can see them because on their dashboard, they're able to look at them, all right? There it is. So there they go. They can see all the orders where they're stacked. All they got to do is look at it and say, man, I got a ton of buy stops down there, all right? So they move the currency down to where the buy stops are. Yes, it is. It's always easy to see after the fact, Donald. See, you can see that's after the fact, after the fact. You can always see it after the fact. But the problem is we have to understand that we're in it before it happens, which is why the ABC is so important to us, all right? See that? So when you see that they have the first pulse, here's the first one, and they're not successful and they pop up, you know that's the B wave, all right? Wait for the C to the downside, take it there, and you're in good shape, all right? Here's another one, A, B, little one, C, right there, see that? And exactly right, Robin. Exhaustion wicks help forecast that. They tell you ahead of time, right here. All right. They tell you ahead of time. We make the candles big. All right. Two things do it: close and reverse, and exhaustion wicks. All right. So here's the exhaustion wick to the upside. What did that tell you? There are no buyers. We exhausted all the buyers. They're gone. Okay. To the downside, what do we got? Exhaustion wick to the upside, and then another close in reverse. The result of that was this right here. See that? The chart told you exactly what it was. Nice job, Robin, as always. All right. So it's pretty clear to see the pullbacks here, all right, versus a retracement. All right. Here's a pullback. All right. It's much bigger than a retracement, but it's a small move in comparison to the move before it. You see that? So what are they typically going to? Which fib are they typically shooting for here? Which fib? Come on. There's a 50%, all right? 50%. Unsustainable trends, Stephanie, would be, unsustainable moves would be the 382. But they're looking for the 50%, and they hope they get the 618, because if they got the 618 to the downside, it's more profit to the upside. Let's pop a fib on both of these. We'll start over here, all right, on this one right here. Let's see what they did, all right? Swing low, swing high, 618. They love a 618. If they can get to the 618, they're all over that right there. All right. So there it is. Now over here. So we start looking at the 50. And if they don't show any signs, we look at the 618. Here's one from here, right here to here. What do we got? 50% on the nose right there. See that? Boom. Up they go. All right. So these are pullbacks. These are little retracements, and you can live through any retracement. The pullback is what you got to worry about, because that's going against your stop. Yeah, a retracement's going against your stop, but it's 22 pips, 28, 30, 17, something like that. Pullbacks are a different story. All right. So when you know you have an ABC in play, all right, what do? You measure the ABC. All right. So you measure it. All right. We'll just do it manually from here to here, right there. Then there's your B. All right, so let's see what the C wave looks like. What everybody say? It's roughly the same. See that? All right, so because you know you're in an ABC pullback, and the pullback is my what? What is the pullback? My friend, exactly right. It's my friend, all right? So, and don't worry about it. I knew what you were saying, Donald. So what do I want? I want that pullback. That pullback is great. Here's two reasons why the pullback is great. One of them is this pullback says we're going up. That's the first thing. All right. And then what is the other thing the pullback tells you? The other thing the pullback tells you is that the retracement is behind me. Retracement is behind me. See, if the retracement is not behind you, the retracement is in your future. And the ABC tells you how far they're going down, right, Ed? So it's measurable. Now, will it do it 100% of the time? No, nothing does anything 100% of the time in the Forex, all right? What do retail traders want? I want the black and white situation, man. That's what I want. Where's the black and white thing? There is none. You got to learn to be a trader. All right. Notice on this pullback, they knew exactly where the 270 was. They knew exactly where the 618 was. And they knew exactly where the 1270 is. So once they had the pullback to the 50, they knew this was the target, this was the target, and this was the target. All right. Now, once that happens for you, you know this is trade one, this is trade two, this is trade three, this is trade four. See how easy that is to see? Exactly correct, Sai. They even did a perfect card. Sai's a, he's a close and reverse animal. That's what he is. Right, Sai? You love those close and reverses. yeah, I knew it. All right. So, but look, we're in the past. We're in the past. And what are we seeing? We're seeing what they did with the information that was available to them. Your job is to recognize that information. Your job is to recognize that information. If you recognize the information, there's your opportunity. You recognize this information, there's your opportunity. All right? Most people, most retail traders are not information gatherers. It's a skill you have to teach yourself. Stairs on the way up. There you go, Vess. All right? You have to teach yourself to do it. Right? Because most traders are not detail orientated. Right? I deal with traders all day long who they don't watch the videos. They turn on their charts. They go try to set them up. They do all kinds of stuff. And they never watch the videos, even though they're told to do it. They don't ever do it. Why? Well, it's because this is a weakness. All right? The weakness is if you want to be a trader, one of the number one things you got to get used to is detail. All right? And detail. Yeah, there you go. Detail is something retail traders don't have time for. I don't have time for that, man. Where's the indicator? Where's my RVI setting? Where's the slow stochastic? Where's my moving average crossover, man? That's what I want. All right. We also don't want to deal with facts. We don't want to deal with that. You can see quite clearly that the bakers are trading the math. All right. You can see quite clearly that they have organized this thing into something that makes sense. Your job is to use your logic and your analysis to figure all that out. If you don't, you're over here. I think it's going up, man. Believe. All right. Oh, my gosh. I'm in. Oh, no, no. It's coming against me. Oh, no, no. I'm going to click out. Oh, man. I got 8 pips. Awesome, man. I'm a winner. You're a winner. All right. You just won the battle and you just lost the war. All right. So this is constantly a battle between the left brain and the right brain. And the only way you beat it is to teach your left brain to trade. All right. Yeah, but that takes time. Yes, it does. All right. But you have the most perfect situation of all the businesses on the planet. Why? Because you have a school in front of you every single day. Every single day, the school is right here. It's already been printed. It tells you, this is how we traded it. Would you like to learn how we traded it? Because we made 200 pips to the top, and you took 5 to 8 out of here. All right? That's what the average retail trader gets, 5 to 8 pips. That's all they get, 5 to 8 pips. All right, good time to bring this in. All right. So there was a study done a couple months ago by Forex Broker Inc. They did a contest, and they took a look at after the contest was over, and they analyzed all of the accounts that lost money, and they found out that those people were right 64% of the time. 64% of the time, they got it right. What was their problem? Their average pip capture was 5.7 pips, 5 to 8 pips. That's it. All right. Now, all the winning trades, they analyzed them. They were slightly better at finding a trade. 70%, 6% better is all they were. All right. But their winning trade averaged 36.49, and every one of those accounts won. So here's your choice right here. Winner or loser? Your choice. All right. I can't make you do it, but those are the facts. All right. Most traders, once they get a little bit of skill, yeah, look at those losses. Yeah, exactly. Most traders, once they get some skill, can trade at 60, 65%. And by the way, that's all a bank trader needs to trade, 65%. That's all he needs to be able to trade at, because his losses will only be 35% and his winners will be 65%. And when you're trading 20,000 standard lots as your standard trade, that's a whole lot of money and you can absorb the 35%. Right? Now, in that case I just showed you, the winning trader, the losing traders were 64% right in track with the bankers. What was their problem? They didn't take it to target. They didn't use the information to tell them what was happening. Not one bit. All right. So pullback. What happened here? Did we make a lower high? A lower low? No, we didn't. See that? In order to make that lower low, they got to come down here, right in here to make that lower low. And you would never let that go that far back. When it doesn't make a turn, you click it out if you're in the buy. All right. That's all there is to it. All right. So they didn't make a lower low. All right. And therefore, they made the turn, and there's the result of that. Let's look at another chart. All right. Somebody pick a chart. I'll look at any chart you want. Just pick whoever gets it first, gets it. GN. All right. Pound New Zealand. All right. So you can see we've got a flag pattern here, possibly going to break this thing to the downside. We don't have that information yet. We have divergence right now. So let's go back in the past. There's a flash crash. Here's a flash crash. You see that? All right. That set that up. How did they know to take that trade? There's the low. There's the low. You see that? Higher low. Higher low. At the trend wall, for that matter. See that? All right. Then we have a little pullback here. It's really a retracement right there. All right. But you can see what they did. Here's what they did with that information right there. That's what they did. All right. There's the school. All right. How did they know to do that? They knew to do that because of the structure. The structure was an uptrend, moving averages going up, moving averages headed up. Yeah, you broke the moving average, but all it did was flatten this thing out. All right. That's all it did. Close and reverse down here with an exhaustion wick. Channel wall helped you exactly right. What does MACD say? What's MACD telling you? MACD says you're going to go up. You're going to go up. So what do? They took all that information, and that's what they did with it. Right there it is. The school is in the past. 3 hours for every 1 hour you spend live, folks. If you're not spending 3 hours for every 1 hour live, you're going to fall behind. You're going to fall behind. They slam dunked it up. That's exactly right. Okay. So here's another flash crash. There's two. Look at this. So in the pound New Zealand, if you were to study this, which you should if you're going to trade it, Andrew, who runs the London room when he can do it, Andrew studied the pound New Zealand for 8 months before he ever made a trade. 8 months, day in, day out, before he ever made a trade. But he knew what the currency is going to do. All right. So he always knew that the tendency of the currency was flash crash, all right? See? That's it. So that's why this is when your stop counts. Okay. This is when the stop counts. Right? Well, 8 months worth. I don't know. It's crazy, right? All right. So you got little flash crashes. They're not ABCs. They're not ABCs. There's another one. That's not an ABC. Notice that? That's not an ABC. That's not an ABC. All right. What are they telling you? That's the personality of the currency. All right. So if I'm going to trade a pound New Zealand, and I went back from time immemorial on a 60-minute chart as far back as I could go, and I watched every retracement, I took a legal pad, and I want to learn this pound New Zealand. I get a legal pad, and I put pound New Zealand up at the top. All right. And then I put, you know, like ABC, bear flag, bull flag, whatever it happens to be, and flash crash. Okay. And as I'm going through, I go flash crash, flash crash, flash crash, flash crash, ABC, flash crash. Flash crash, flash crash, flash crash, ABC. All right. And then by the time I get 300 of these, and this is the overwhelming information that the chart says that it does, now I know what to expect. All right. If I'm going to trade the pound New Zealand, I'll expect flash crashes. So most important thing in a flash crash is my stop. All right. My stop has got to be able to hold a flash crash. All right. That's why your stop is so important, that if you make the trade up here, right? Now, remember, if you know it's a flash crash, you're not going to get an ABC. You're looking for other information. What information did they show you here? Close and reverse, close and reverse, close and reverse. How about that? What are they trying to do? Three close and reverses to the upside. Are they trying to go up? Yeah, they're trying to go up. They're talking to each other. Yeah, see, that's what they're doing. All right. So be aware of your currency. Each currency has a personality. There's an ABC right there. All right. So not much of one, but it is one. All right. Then a sideways movement here. Let's see what we got over here. Another little pullback, another little flag. All right, here we go. Over here, we got, what do we got? We got a flash crash. We got an ABC. We got a flash crash. We got a flash crash. All right. So four pullbacks there. Three of them were flash crashes. Only one was an ABC. What does that tell you about the pound New Zealand? We only looked at a few of them right now. But what's the overwhelming thing the chart says that it does in a pullback? Overwhelming right now. Flash crash. Flash crash. All right. So if you're going to trade it, you need to know that. All right. Where's the ABC? It ain't happening. Not on this currency. All right. Somebody mentioned the Aussie dollar. I'd like to do that because that's a beginner's currency. So let's go over here. It's one of the reasons you should trade the beginner's currency is because of that. Let me see what that dollar's doing. Dollar still, you know, dang. They may turn this tonight. You can see right here, MACD says this. So they may go ahead and turn it, although they're not getting any traction right now, but they may turn it. All right. We'll see. You can also see the euro does flash crashes. That's what it does. So, the dollar, nasty. Right now it's nasty. All right. So let's go back in the past. That's our school is the past. All right. We're looking for a pullback. That's a retracement. That's a retracement. This is a pullback. It doesn't look like much here because it's the Aussie dollar and the Aussie dollar has a small ATR. All right. So you pull up the ATR and you look at the ATR and the Aussie dollar is 67 pips. All right. So you got 100 pip stop on 130 or lots. All right. Which is the stop policy, roughly 100 pip loss. That's three times the technical stop. All right. So in order to stop you out, if you took a buy up here, it's going to have to do 100. It's ATR plus 30 more pips to get your stop. That's possible. But it's not probable. And it's possible only if it reverses. And it could do that because of the dollar index. All right. It's got a dollar index tied to this thing. All right. So we had a little pullback here. All right. What was it? Nothing. A, B, C. Robin's point. Exhaust in wicks. Up they go. Well, why didn't they do a close in reverse? Because they don't do them here. They do exhaust in wicks. All right, over here, what do they do? Close and reverse here. See, so you got to be prepared for everything. What was that? A, B, C. Can everybody see the size is the same? A, C. Same size, A, B, C. All right, how'd they do this one? A, B, C. See that? What are they doing? All right, that's a pullback. That's a retracement. That's a pullback. All right, you see that? All right. All righty. Anybody got any questions on that? Everybody good? Spend some time. You know, watching me do it for, 45 minutes is not a big deal. Going out and spending hours on your own is where you're going to learn it, not because Scott just showed you it. That'll get you nowhere. If you go look at it, go practice it, go into school. The school is available to you. All you got to do is click the chart backwards. That's all you got to do. There you go, Matt. Okay. And you asked the question, Matt. So there you go. So you can see in this area, that's the only pullback right there. All right. So there it is. All right. How did they get everybody to do it? Close and reverse. There's a result of that. See that? All right. How'd they do this one? A, B, C. Set up that whole move. It'll be tomorrow, Greg. I don't get it back until later tonight. And by the time I get it back, I'm sleeping. So I put them up tomorrow. All right, everybody. Hope that helped you. I will talk with you soon. Have a great day, everybody. And be careful. We'll see you later. Yep, you bet.